writing a validation rule in an object, how many fields you can able to show error in one validation rule? Only one field, right? Either you can choose at a field level or either at a top of the page, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah. Now, let's consider I have a complex validation rules. Let's say I have a validation rule based on other object, based on other object, which I do not have any relationship. Then, if that is something I need to do validation, then it would be a problem for me, because without relationship, we can't navigate to that object, and even we don't know how to, which record we need to look for, right? So Apex trigger is capable, even you can do a complex validations, which is not possible in a validation rule. And also, one Apex trigger is enough to validate all your fields and forms. One Apex trigger is enough. You don't want to write a multiple validation rules, okay? And validation rules, I mean, Apex trigger is also capable to automate your business. Let's say if I create something, I need to send an email, or I need to say that this need to be submitted for approval. So whatever you can able to configure, that can be implemented through Apex trigger also. If something is not standardized, then you can, I mean, if something is not an out-of-box solution, if you want to implement that, Apex trigger will gonna help you in doing that, okay? So first thing, Apex triggers comes with a different variables, like trigger context variables. We have a concept called trigger context variables. What are trigger context variables? We have trigger dot is insert, trigger dot is update, trigger dot is delete, trigger dot is undelete. You can see, even you can fire a record while undeleting. Undeleting in the sense, restoring the deleted record while deleting, updating, or inserting. You can't do a validation for the deletion of a record, but you can able to do here. Clear? And undelete is also same thing, that you can't do validation for a undeletion, but still you can able to do. Clear? I think, like, if the trigger is insert, in a sense, if the trigger is running for inserting record, then you will get is insert. If the trigger is updating, I mean, if the record is getting updated, then trigger.isUpdate will return true. The same way, if the record is getting deleted, isDelete equal to true. And trigger.isDelete, if you are restoring, then it will return true. So these are the trigger context variables as the first part. And we also have trigger dot, we have another thing called trigger dot new, trigger dot new map, trigger dot old, trigger dot old map. Let's say if I'm updating multiple records at one shot, if I'm updating multiple records at one go, then trigger dot new. If I'm updating, in a sense, we have a record already existing in the system and we are changing something. So it means that you have both old data and new data together, right? Because this is an existing record, you are modifying it. So you will be having a new data and old data of that record, right? If the record I am inserting for a first time, then old data will not come. Only new data will come. Only old data will not come. New data will come, right? Because record is getting created for the first time. If the record is getting created for the first time, you will be having only trigger.new and trigger.new map information. There would be no traces for a old information like old and old map. And the same way follows the undelete. Undelete is something, right? You are restoring from the recycle bin. You are restoring from the recycle bin. When you are restoring something from the recycle bin, the system will treat that particular record as a new record, new insertion. You understand? If you are trying to undelete, undelete in the sense, you are deleted one record, now you are restoring back, then when you are restoring back, you will get, the system will treat that record as a new record, inserting record, not like a updating record, because it is something very new which is getting generated in the system. Clear? Clear?
Escape it.
Yeah. We have also called trigger events. We have different events like before insert, after insert, before update, after update, before delete, after delete, after undelete. Here you need to observe, insert, update and delete, we have both events. We can able to validate, we can run a trigger both before insert and a record is not yet created, it is about to create that time, and after record is getting created. You can run everything before and after for insert, update and delete. For undelete, you can able to run your trigger only after it is undeleted, only after event you need to observe here, right? Only after event you need to observe. Because we have like a is insert, right? Let's say the trigger is running before insert. How can I know that is insert is true for only for after update? So we need to understand which event also. Even for this, we have a trigger context variables called trigger.isBefore. Hope this explains. And trigger.isAfter. If I say trigger.isAfter and trigger.isInsert, then you'll get like after insert, right? If I put an and condition inside my conditional operator, then what happens? You'll get after insert, trigger.isAfter and trigger.isInsert. If both becomes true, then execute. When this both becomes true, if it is after insert, clear? Clear?
Stupid.
Yeah. How the data will store in new one new map? Trigger.new one new map, data will store in the list of S object. Here it will store list of S objects. And here it will store map of ID, S object. When I say ID, ID is nothing but your 16 or 18 character, 15 or 18 characters ID of Salesforce record. You know, right, where ID is. Whenever you create a record, you will get an ID at top of the page, right? If I go to my accounts, now this is my ID. Okay. Now we'll see one by one how this works. Let's say a simple trigger. To create a trigger, you can create an either ways, but I'm creating from a developer console. I'm creating from a developer console. New, and you can choose Apex trigger. And you need to mention your trigger name. Let's say I'm mentioning account trigger. And on which object you need to write? I need to write my trigger on my account object, submit. Now you can see the trigger is trigger keyword, account name, I mean trigger name on which object, account object, which event before insert. Before going further, what I'll do, I just take off my validation rule inside my account. Accounts. Validation rules, I just deactivate it. Edit. Now, this is a before insert, right? The best practice always when you are writing your trigger, let's say, you need to write every business logic inside in account trigger control. Account trigger handler. This is the trigger framework that we follow in real time, right? We don't write any code inside our Apex trigger. We'll write everything under Apex classes. So here we have before insert, right? How can I check my before insert? As per the context variables, if condition, I'll say trigger.isBefore and trigger dot is insert. Trigger dot is insert. Apex language is not a case sensitive language. You can type however you want it. But as per the readability and standardization, I am following the camel case for variables and method names, and Pascal case for the name of a trigger or a class. So as soon as you mentioned, now I'll come back to my Apex class. I'll create one method. How to create a method syntax? Access specifier, static or non-static keyword. I'll say static, void, return type, and method name. Right? This is the syntax that we follow. Before, insert. Now I'll say trigger dot new. Sorry. List of. Because what is this object called? Account. You'll get account data. So new list, comma. We also have a map called map of ID, comma, account. So here I'm giving it. So you don't get a final output here because I wanted to show how data is coming and new and map. I mean in the new map and new map, new old map. Sorry. Trigger.new and trigger.new map, we have a data, right? In, as I said before, in while insert, you will be having these two records. So I just wanted to show what happens, how the difference will come from before and after. How the difference will come from before and after. Now I'll say how to call my Apex method. If it is a static method, how to call? Class name. You can access static methods based on its class name, right? So yes. Now, class name dot this one. And what type of data we have? Both trigger dot new comma trigger dot new map. Trigger dot new and trigger dot new map. So now we don't have anything to do with the trigger because we are passing all the information, whatever we have through the here. So before writing any logic, I wanted to show you something, whether we are getting ID or not. So let's say ID, new list ID equal to, how to get only one record from the new list, because this is the list. We can pass index, right? I'll say the first record 0.id. I can do this, right? We can put an index so that if I have a 10 elements, if I put a 0, then what happens? The first element will come, isn't it? The same way, ID, new map ID equal to, how to get a values from new app? There is a method called dot values. Dot values in the sense, it will get all the values in the form of list and I'm passing 0. Dot ID. So I'll get, now what I'll do, I'll throw an error. System dot add of zero dot name error or error. I am adding an error saying that first I'll add new list ID. First I'll add new list ID plus, and then I'll say semicolon colon plus I'll add my new map ID. Save. First, we need to understand whether we are getting IDs, whether we are getting IDs if the record is getting inserted for the first time. If the record is getting inserting, I mean before insert, do we have a record ID or not? Now, I'm going back my account. New. I'll say test. If I save, what happened? Apex trigger uncounted system exception. Null pointer exception. What happening here? Attempt to dereference the classified line number 5 on column 1. What is line number 5? Now, here we'll say, instead of this, I'll display. For one thing is clear that we don't get an ID. We didn't get an ID. Let's say semicolon. I just commented out. We'll see. What is this? Control Z. So here it is. We didn't get an ID. We didn't get an ID from the new map. We got an error. So let's say what happens here. New map ID, no. Here it is, new map. I'll try to save now again. We got null, right? Imagine one thing, we got new ID is null, new list ID is 1, I mean new list ID is not there. So if the record is creating for the first time and if it is in the event called before insert, then we don't get a record IDs, then we don't get a record IDs, clear? And let's say, you can say that, oh, why new map itself is null, there is no information on map record if it is a before insert. So in the before insert, better, there is a rule saying that you should not use your map to render your information. If you use your map, then there is a problem because in map, you don't get an ID. Because key is ID, the key is null, so you don't generate a map. Now I'll try to display my new list directly. I try to display my new list. Now, you got some information in the new list, isn't it? What is your ID, name equal to test? You got this information, isn't it? Test, I just provided, let's say test, Deepak, I'll say phone number. So if I click save, what happens? You'll get all this information. Now you can see test, Deepak, shipping, Bangalore, and all this. So it means very clear in the before insert event, you will be having only record information called trigger.new. You will only have information called trigger.new. There will be no information, there will be no traces for trigger.new map. So imagine if you are focused on writing a before insert event, then try to use only trigger.new, not trigger.map. Clear to this point? Any questions? Any questions on this? Okay, perfect. So you understand, right? My intention of writing this is just wanted to clear that we don't get an ID, so only we don't get a map information in the before insert. Whenever you are writing a before insert, always in writing trigger.new is the only information you will get it. Now, because this is a list, how to iterate a list? So we can iterate a list by saying for open braces, closer braces, and list data type, what is account, I'll say data, colon, and the list of records, and the list of records. Now what happens, the iteration will go record by record, and this is called for each statement. So we got record by record information. Now what we can do, we can check if data dot phone equal to null, I'll say data dot yard error, please verify the error from the trigger, from the account trigger. This is at a, I am showing two places, data.error in the sense I am adding a record at a, error at a record level, at a account level. Now what I will do, I will add a error at a phone level. data.phone.addError, phone is blank. So this is called page level. If you are mentioning add error directly at a record, at an account level, then this is called page level error. If you are keeping a phone dot error, this is at a field level. Now I'm throwing two errors. In validation rule, either you can choose this or this, but I'm showing two errors together, right? Now what I'll do, I'll just click save. Oh, that's it.
Phone number field is already provided.
That's what I clicked to say. I can't use that record anymore.
Okay.
So mail account, I'll say say. You can see please verify error from the account record. This is at a yard error. This is at yard error. And you got another error saying that phone is blank from the this level, but I just wanted to know whether this record is already exists or not in the name of Sunil. So I think we have already have Sunil record, right? Sunil account, isn't it? We don't have. We have one. We already have one. Now I need to identify if my account name is same. If I'm trying to create a record, I need to throw error. If the account name is same, I need to understand my duplications also. So this is how you will add an error. So let's say I wanted to understand whether my information is, existing data is already there or not. So what I need to do, I'll say set string account names equal to new set of string. So what I will do, I will add all my account names to the whatever data I am creating now, I will add to my account names. So what I will do, here I will say account names dot add method only, right? We wanted to use if we want to pass your information. So what I am doing here, I am adding all the account names to a new set variable. So now I got my account data. Now I'll see if the account names are greater than 0. If account names dot size greater than 0, what I'll do, I'll query my accounts. How to query accounts? List of account, list of account, account world equal to, how to query the information, select ID comma name from account where name, because this is not a single value, we have multiple values. When you have more than one value, you need to use the operator called in, and because this is not a values, so instead of using in, if you are referring any variable, you need to use colon followed by and then your variable name. So what happens, it checks, it tries to retrieve the data based on the account information available. So what we need to write, for, and whatever I am saying is the basic code, we need to update it. Now because I am iterating my account ACC old data colon account old. Now we got our name. Here I am getting a name, but how I can retrieve my account information based on the account name? For that, what we have to do, map of string comma account name map equal to map of string comma account. So what I'm doing, I just created a set for account names and I'm just creating for a map. So the problem is that I don't think we need a set now. What I'll do, instead of this, we can say name map dot put data name comma data, and instead of new name map, and you can say dot key set is the one, you will get all the keys from the list. This one, this is what we discussed, this key set means. me, so the queue would continue here. Dot keyset dot size dot keyset dot size. Now we got it. Now how can I get my old record? Account current SEC equal to how to get in data from new map? Base run key dot get. Put means you are updating. Get means you are retrieving. Whole data dot name. Now, if I say if current SSC not equal to null, then current SSC dot add error. This is a duplicate record for old record . So what happened? I'm saying a duplicate error. Because if the record is not null based on the account name, then we can say that this is already existing from the query. If the data is there, if it is not null, then what happens? You'll get an error. Clear? No. I'll try to create a record called Sunil again. New account name Sunil. I'll say duplicate record for the old record. This is a duplicate record for the old records. This one. Now, if I go to this old record, this is actual data of Sunil record, Sunil account. You can see this is the data. So, how we are doing this? Here we are. We need to observe two things. This is the first validation block. Let's say if the field is required or not required. On top of that, we also have another condition saying that if the record should not be duplicated. If the record should not be duplicated, what we should do? We should be able to query the existing information, right? So to query the existing information, we need to know the name field first. So what I did, I added to a name field, to a set, and then queried. Now the problem came for me that while iterating, I know my account name. Based on account name, I should be able to retrieve the current record which are getting created. So what I did for that, instead of set, I used map. Map in the sense of the key is string. String in the sense goes account name and then account. I mean, I am also showing an account and then name field and string comma account name. You understood this? So now I added my list. Now what happens? For the old accounts, I'm iterating. While iterating, what happens? I'm trying to pass my account name from the old record, from the existing records, and querying and getting the information from the map variable, which we declared at a line number 4. If the value from the map return is not equal to null, if the value exists, then it will return not equal to null. If the data is not equal to null, it means the data is already existing. So when the data is existing, I'm throwing an error, adding an error saying that this is a duplicate record for the old record. And for a reference, user reference, I'm also passing my old account ID. Because this is the same, because you are inside one iteration, so you'll be having old data as same as the account, current account matching details. Clear?
Deepak, one question.
Yeah.
So for the 19th line, do we need to check whether that map contains this key, like new map dot contains?
If you want to try to retrieve something like this, if you are trying to retrieve value from it, then you need to check. If you are not retrieving, you are just trying to get the data. If the map key is existing, then it will return some value. If the key is not existing, then it will become null. We are checking null only. We are not trying to read any value from the null.
Okay.
Clear?
Okay. Deepak, can you test once by giving some other phone number which is not existed?
This is an account name. So I'll say the Sunil account one. Okay. This is on phone, not on phone number. This is there on account name. That is what we are doing. Name of an account. So we can say name. So I'm changing my Sunil name. So it will save now. Clear?
Yes, yes. Okay.
If the name matches, exact matches, then it will throw error.
Okay.
Any question on this? Nikhil?